Multibeam filters. In this movie, we will demonstrate the use of multibeam filters online and offline, the different filters offered by PDS, and area filters. Notice, deleted or filtered data in PDS is flagged. The raw data remains untouched. This means you can always revert back to the raw data. All data, raw and processed, is stored in the same PDS file. The processed data is used throughout all modules of PDS, such as the grid model editor. Multibeam filters may be used in the online PDS real-time acquisition or in the offline processing application. Let's first take a look to the real-time acquisition. Press in real-time at the multibeam filters and sound velocity button to add or remove multibeam filters. The multibeam filters dialog opens. Press the add filter button to add a multibeam filter. Select the filter. Press OK. And set the filter settings. Press OK when finished. To delete a filter, open the filter dialog again. Untick the checkbox of the filter and press OK. In the processing, we will describe the used filters. Let's see how we can use filters in the processing. Start the processing and press the filters button. Open the filter page. The files of the selected file set are indicated in the file bar. These files are also listed in the filter position box. Each file starts with a filter position. For each filter position is the applied filter listed in the filter box. Select a filter position and see the applied filter. Besides the start filter position, it is possible to add a new filter position. Select in the view or file bar the position to start the filter. And press the insert button. The new filter position includes the filters already added to the file. Press the add filter button to add a new filter. Select the filter. Always press the apply button to apply filter changes. The arrows in the file bar indicate filter positions. To delete a filter position with its applied filters, select the filter position and press the delete button. To add the filter to multiple filter positions, hold the control key and select the filter positions. Press the add filter button to add the filter to all selected filter positions. To select multiple filter positions, it is also possible to select a filter position, holding the Shift key and selecting another filter position. All filter positions in between are selected. Press the Add filter button to add the filter to all selected filter positions, as we did before. Select the filter and set the filter setting. Press Apply to apply the changes. If you select multiple filter positions and you see a filled checkbox instead of a ticked one, this means this filter is not added to all selected filter positions. Unselect a checkbox and press the Apply button to delete a filter. Press the Discard button to discard a filter change. Let's now discuss filters in the processing. First, we increase the added circle size to show more high-resolution data in the view. The area increases. To show disturbance more clear, we connect the beams with lines, as we see. Select to show only the valid beams to see only the cleaned, filtered data. Unselect to see all data. Change the column mode. And select Filter to distinguish the used filters of the file set. Or select File Set to distinguish the files of the file set. Or we want to see just depths. Let's take a look to the available multibeam filters in PDS. The first filter we will discuss is the beam reject filter. This filter rejects selected beams. Let's take a look to the next file. We add the filter. Set the beams to reject, separated by a comma. So we have this data. And now we apply this filter. These selected beams are rejected, as we can see. You can use this filter when the multibeam has defective beams, or for instance when the multibeam is pole mounted and one side of the soundings is blocked by the ship's hull. Next, the amplitude detection filter. This filter rejects amplitude detections after a set number of phase detections. Some multibeam systems do amplitude detections for the nadir sector and phase detections for the outer sector. A amplitude detection in an outer sector may disturb the data. This filter filters this. Let's see the disturbance in the next dataset. We select all filter positions, add the filter, set the filter setting. So we see our disturbance, and after applying the filter, it is cleaned. And now the range filter. The range filter rejects the beams outside the set range limit. Let's take a look to the next file set where we see some disturbance. We add the filter. The set range limits are relative to the sonar. When we have applied the filter, we see that our disturbance have been removed, but unfortunately now also real data have been removed. So be careful with your range limits. Let's change them. So now only the disturbance is removed. This filter may be useful if there is, for instance, disturbance close to the sonar transducer. And now the depth filter. The depth filter rejects the beams falling outside the depth limits. If we have a more or less flat seabed, then we can filter noise around the bottom detection. So let's take a look to the next file set with some disturbance. It is sometimes hard to see in the area viewer the depths related to the disturbance. In this case, we can create a profile view. Right-click in the area view. Select from the context menu Create Detail View and select the Create Profile View menu item. Draw a profile box. And there we have our profile, where we can see our depths. So now we add our depth filter. Set the depth limits with reference to the sea level. And when we apply the filter, we see that our disturbance is removed. Be careful with your defined limits. If they are set too tight, real data may be removed, as we see. And now the slope filter. A beam is rejected if the angle between two adjacent points and the pane is higher as a set angle. In the next file set we see disturbance. But when we add the slope filter, we will see that our disturbance is removed. However, also our object is now removed. So let's use the intersection filter. This filter rejects the middle point of three points if the enclosed angle of the three points is smaller as the set value. So we remove the slope filter and add the intersection filter. We set our angle. And when we apply the filter, we see that our disturbance is removed, but our object is still there. Add now the flying object filter. This filter rejects each beam that is too high in relation to the sea bottom. Let's see the next file set with some disturbance. We add the filter. Set our filter settings. We apply the filter. And our flying objects have been removed. You may use this filter if there is disturbance in the water column. Now the nadir filter. The nadir filter rejects points outside a set port and starboard angle with respect to the nadir. This filter is ideal if there is disturbance at the outer beams. Add the filter. Set the angle or distance with respect to the nadir. And as you see, the outer beams are rejected. Then another filter is the statistic filter. This filter rejects points if they differ a certain percentage from a median value obtained from a set number of points. If we have spikes in the data, and we add this filter, and we set the size and the strictness of this filter, and we see a lot of spikes are rejected. The statistic filter adjusts itself to the roughness of the seafloor. It is a commonly used filter. And now the IHO filter. With applying this filter, are beams rejected that don't meet a set IHO order. Let's add this filter. Set the IHO order. Press apply. And in this example, almost none data is rejected. A other filter we can add is the TPE custom error filter. Beams are rejected that don't meet the set TPE value. If we add this filter. And we set our maximum TPE error. And press apply. And we see data is rejected which didn't meet the specified allowed error. These last two filters are in general used when specified by the customer. And now the detection quality filter. This filter is used for Raison multibeam systems. These systems output the coherency and brightness quality. Beams that don't meet the quality are rejected. Let's see the next file set with disturbance. We add this filter. We set the required detection quality. Press Apply. And we see our disturbance is removed. This filter is in general always added if Raison sonars are used. Besides filters, PDS also supports area filters. Area filters were introduced with multi-detect data. Open the area filter page. Set in the area viewer the color mode to multi-detect to see the multi-detect data. As we see. An area filter may contain more filter sets. Select a existing filter set or press the new button to create a new one. Let's create a new one. Enter a name. Select or create a new area. So let's create a new one. Enter a name. Select for the area the corresponding polygon or create a new polygon. Press this button to draw a new polygon. Draw the polygon. Enter a name. The next step is to add a filter to this area. Press the Add Filter button. Add the filter. Only three filters apply for multi-detect data. More filters may be added to the same area. Press the Add Filter button again. And add your other filter. A same filter set may include more area filters. So we add another area. Select or create a polygon. And add one or more filters to this area. Press this button to apply our selected area filters to the data. Using PDS multibeam filters to create nice datasets.
Teledyne RESON, everywhere you look.